Hi, I'm Skill Singh, and welcome to part 3 of Digital Accessibility series. In this video, we will make text boxes, checkboxes, and buttons ADA compliant. Let's start with the text boxes. It is one of the most important elements used to gather user information, such as first name, last name, date of birth, and so on. Here are the key things to make a text box ADA compliant. First, user should be able to click on the label to reach the linked text box. Second, screen readers such as JAWS or NVIDIA should read what information to enter. And third, user should have the visual clues of the format in which the data is needed. Now let's jump into our code and make a text box ADA compliant. We'll be using the same HTML that we worked on in our previous lessons. Here is the link that you can use to revisit it. Let's change the header here. We'll call this as sign up page. And within the section, let's remove this paragraph and simply have a label. And we'll call it as first name. And let's add another input of type text here. We'll be inputting the first name here. Now we have our first name label and a text box in our browser. The first requirement is that user should be able to click on this label and it should take users to the text box, which is not happening in this case. Now let's get back to our HTML. For the input, I will add an ID. I'll say txt f name, and then let's copy this one and add an attribute for, and then copy paste it. Now that we have a linked label with the text box, whenever a user clicks on first name, focus should go to the text box. Next, we want users to understand the meaning of this label, right? In case we want to add additional information, we can do it by adding an ARIA label. So let's use ARIA attribute here. I'll say ARIA label equals to, and then we can put a custom message here. We can say, please enter your first name. It is a required field. Now whenever a screen reader like JAWS is running, instead of reading first name colon, it will read please enter your first name. It is a required field, and then we can make this input as required. And to symbolize it, we can have a star here. We are not worried, or we are not working on the CSS or styling in this section, so we'll be focusing on making the element ADA compliant. Next is to add a visual display or a helping text which can give a more or a clear understanding of the input required. Let's take an example of a date of birth. Let's add another label. We'll say for equals to, I'll give that input type name as txt dob, and then I'll say d colon e dot b, and then we'll have our input. We'll give type as text. I'm taking text box as an example here, not worried about the masking in this video. Say txt dob. Make sure the name matches with what we have in the for as to link the label and the text box. Now when I click on this, my focus goes to the text box. When we say formatting or the visual help, we are talking about what kind of format this text box expects. We can say we'll want it to be mm first, ad followed by year. This is one way of achieving it. The only drawback that we have over here is it has very limited feature or limited scope of designing or adding a CSS style here. The other approach that we can follow is we can add a span element. We can have an ID to it. We can say span textdob. And then within this we can have the text mem/dd/wifi. And then we can use another by area attribute. We can say area labeled by, and then we can give a couple of IDs here. Let's give an ID for this label as well. We'll say ID equals to lvldob. So let's give this ID first within this area labeled by space, and then this text box, or sorry, span element. Now when a JAWS or a screen reader is reading, it will read DOB and then this format. Now let's remove this one. We have a simple label, then we have a text box followed by the format helper. Now this gives us flexibility of designing this section using the CSS. We'll not be covering the CSS parts here. I'll be leaving a link down below for the GitHub library that you can access the entire code. Next, we have checkboxes. Checkboxes are used to make selection among different options. There are two states, checked and unchecked. All checkboxes should be selectable using spacebar keys, and a screen reader should read the linked label or div copy text. Let's get back to our code to make checkboxes ADA compliant. Okay, now let's add another header. I'll say h3 and we'll ask your favorite brand. And under this, let's create a div. I'll have a role which is a var role. We'll call it as group. And then we will say area labeled. We'll say area labeled by equals to lbl header. Okay, now we have our div. Let's copy this and then add an ID to this header. So it will be this one. Next, let's add an input. We will say input type is a checkbox. It is having an ID. It's CHK brand 1. Name, we can say brand 1, and then value we can say gap. Now we need a label. So if you see on your right side, we have a checkbox in place, but we do need a label along with it for users who click on that checkbox. Then we will add a label. We'll say for, we'll copy this ID. This is the practice that I have followed to avoid any spelling mistakes. And then I'll say gap. Alright, now we have our checkbox. If I go back to our browser, click on this gap checkbox, it selects my gap checkbox. So your favorite brand, we can select and unselect using the click keys. Now let me tap back to date of birth and then press spacebar. The selection is gone. If I press spacebar again, I can see it is selected. Now let's copy this section and try to add a couple of more. We'll make slight modifications. I'll change the ID here. We'll say instead of gap, we'll say Tommy here. Then same thing in the visual labels. And then finally for the third checkbox, and say, acha. We can use this suggestion, and then we have to modify this as well for the false, else it will take us to the wrong checkbox. Let's save this, come back to this browser. If I click Tommy, H&M, they are perfectly being selected and unselected as I click on them. The last thing, when a screen reader is reading and a user is using a keyboard, when they tab onto the gap checkbox, it should read the label that we have associated with it. So here we have a div. We say area labeled by LBL header, and LBL header is this H3 header, and we can say your favorite brand. It will read your favorite brand, unselected gap, or selected gap. And then we have buttons, which can be further categorized into two. First, the primary buttons, and second, the secondary buttons. Key callouts to make button ID compliant are, first, user should be able to tab to those buttons and should be able to activate using enter key or spacebar key. Secondly, there should be a meaningful copy text or an alternate text read out for the screen reader users. Let's go back to our studio to make buttons ADA compliant. Alright, now let's come back to our code and try to add a couple of buttons. Before we add buttons, I would like to add a form element. Let's add a form immediately after the section element. And then let's end it immediately before the section element ends. Alright. Now this is the div for the checkboxes. Immediately after this div, let's add a couple of buttons. First, we will try to add a secondary button. I'll say a button, and then give ID, say btn cancel, and then we'll say cancel here. So we have a cancel button on the right side, and then we can add another secondary button. I'll give it an ID equals to btn save, and then give a copy text and call it as save. Now, for the sake of this demo, let me quickly comment this out, this section, and go back to our browser. Now, let's give the required field, I'll say skill sync, and then try to press enter. Just look at this section. My browser will reload the moment I press enter. And this is happening because we have not given any type to this button. And this is again one of the ADA recommendations to make sure your primary buttons are linked to your form element and they are posting the form back to the server. That is the only reason we don't give any type for these buttons. Now let's uncomment the cancel here, and let's add a type to this button. I'll say type equals to button, then some space to it. Now if I comment the save button and go back to my browser, I give the basic details, I'll say skills sync, and then press enter. Nothing happens on the page because the button which was having type as submit by default is commented out, and the button which is our secondary button in this case is having type equals to button. And this will only trigger when we add any JavaScript function or jQuery hook to it. Now let's uncomment this one and then save it. Now let's go back to our browser, test out the tabbing sequence. If these two buttons are tappable, yes, both of these buttons, primary and secondary buttons, are tappable, and user can make a selection by pressing the enter or spacebar keys. The last thing to cover for screen reader users, right? Save, we can add another copy text or an alternate text for the screen reader users. We can say area label, and here we can give some meaningful or some helpful copy text. We can say save your preferences. Now, when the screen reader or JAWS is running and you tabs onto this button, it will read out as save your preferences button. Congratulations! You are on the right path to develop accessible web applications. In this video, we cover text boxes, checkboxes, and buttons. In our next video, we will cover radio buttons, hyperlinks, and images. Please like, share, and subscribe to this channel when you find it helpful.